Next, we'll discuss the addition of vectors. So in addition of vectors, we have two methods. One is graphical method. Another one is analytical method, or also we can call it as a component method. And this is we can also call it as a component method. So first we will go to the discussion of graphical method, and later we will discuss, after completing the resolution of vectors, we will go to the discussion of analytical method. So first we will go to the graphical method. So what is the procedure in the graphical method? Let us suppose we take two vectors. Here, vector A bar. So first I am taking the case of, if vectors are in the same line, if two vectors are in the same line, let us suppose a vector A bar and a vector B bar, these two vectors are in the same line. If you want to add these two vectors, so first you have to observe that the tail of the first vector, here it is there, and head of the second first vector is here, it is there. Now you should be joining the tail of the second vector to head of the first vector. Then if you join like that, the resultant will be the summation of the two vectors A bar plus B bar. So now if I am adding the tail of the second vector to the head of the first vector, now this will be the combination. So this is A bar and B bar. Now this resultant will be the, we can call it as a R bar, that is equivalent to A bar plus B bar. So what is the procedure we follow? You can understand that. So if you want to add two vectors, the tail of the second vector you have to connect to the head of the first vector, and the tail of the first vector to the head of the second vector gives the resultant vector, that is A bar plus B bar. That is, we can see that if they are in the same line, we did like this. Next we go to the, if two vectors, if make certain angle, then how can we add those? Next, if two vectors makes an angle, any arbitrary angle you can take it. Let us suppose if this is a A bar vector and this is a B bar vector. Now we want to add these two. They are not in the same line. Now if you want to add these two, what is the procedure we followed here? We discussed that the tail of the second vector you have to connect it to the head of the first vector, and join the tail of the first vector to the head of the second vector. That will use the resultant of A bar and B bar. Now if you add these two like this, it will be there. This is A bar vector, as usual I am writing, and B bar vector tail you have to connect it to the A bar vector head. This is B bar vector tail connected to the A bar vector head. Now if I line join the tail of the A bar vector to B bar vector, this will give us the resultant of these two vectors, that is R bar equal to A bar plus B bar. So the addition of two vectors by making an angle, we will call this as also as a triangle of vector addition. So as what is the triangle of vector addition? We will save this thing only, we will be told in another way, that's it. Triangle of vector addition. What is this triangle of vector addition means? If two vectors are there, if they are represented as the two sides of the triangle taken in one direction, otherwise taken in one order. So if this is one vector A bar, this is another vector B bar. Let us suppose these two are two sides of a triangle taken in one particular direction, so in one order. Then if you want to form a triangle, means we need another side, that is the closing side, the closing side we should take in the reverse order. So we took this as an anti-clockwise, then the closing side we have to take this in the clockwise direction, then this will, this closing side will give the resultant of A bar and B bar. So you can call this is also as a triangle of vector addition. So you can understand triangle of vector addition same as the method of two vectors adding if they are having some angle. Next, even here we can discuss the parallelogram law of vector addition also. So how we will discuss the parallelogram of vector addition is, here parallelogram law of vector addition I am giving for some example, then we can discuss this. Suppose here one body was there whose mass is m kg and we are applying two forces over it. One of the force is acting in this direction, which is F1 bar, one vector, force vector. Another vector is like this. This is another force vector, F2 bar. Then, using these two, we can able to construct a parallelogram. You know how to construct a parallelogram means? By drawing the parallel sides. Means F1 vector parallel, we can draw one more vector. So these two are parallel sides are equal. This is also being F1 vector. In the same way, F2 bar here we can displace it, and now this is also be F2 bar. Now you can observe this is nothing but a parallelogram, parallel sides are equal. Now in this parallelogram, what is the resultant? How can we take the resultant means? See, F1 bar, F2 bar resultant will be the diagonal of this parallelogram, which is drawn from the same point where the two vectors were there. So here F1 bar and F2 bar, where we started from here, the resultant will be the diagonal of this parallelogram like this. This is the diagonal of this parallelogram. Then you can see F2 bar vector, F1 bar vector. These two, tail of the F1 bar added to the head of the F2 bar. So this will be what? F2 plus F1. The same way, here the tail of the F2 bar vector added at the, connected at the end of the F1 vector. So this is will be F1 plus F2. So like this, we can able to find the resultant of F1 vector and F2 vector of by using the parallelogram law of vectors. Means you can understand that if two vectors are there, let us suppose P bar vector and Q bar vector, they are co-initial vectors. We know co-initial vectors means the tails are at the same point. Initial points are at the same point. Then if you construct the parallelogram, this is P bar and this will be the Q bar. As we discussed here, how can we get the resultant of this P bar vector and Q bar vector is by drawing the diagonal from the same point where we started the vectors, two vectors. Now if you are connecting these, so we will get a diagonal of it. This diagonal will produce the resultant R bar, that is P bar plus Q bar. So this is the one of the way graphically we can able to discuss the parallelogram of vectors. Next we will go to the discussion of subtraction of vectors. So what is the subtraction of vectors means? Subtraction of vectors is nothing but addition of vectors only. But one vector positive means we have which one we want to be subtracted. That negative vector we have to add to the first vector. That's it. So we'll be discuss that. Subtraction of vectors. Let us suppose we have A bar vector and here we have B bar vector. So like these vectors are there, here A bar vector and B bar vector. procedure we discussed, the head of the first vector is there, no? At that head you have to connect the what second vector, then this will be gives the result. Now if you join this one, actually what you will get, a bar plus b bar, this is addition of vector, this is the result. Now what we are going to do here, subtraction of vector. So subtraction of vector, how can we write here is r bar equal to, actually subtraction of vectors means a bar minus b bar. This can also be write like this, a bar plus of minus b bar. So we are adding the vectors only, but which vectors we are adding? A bar vector and negative of b bar vector. So negative of b bar vector means we discussed yesterday that, so negative vector means same magnitude but the direction is quite opposite. So now we have to displace it reverse. So b bar vector is there, no? So this is, we have to be drawing in the opposite direction by making in the same magnitude, means it will give the negative of b bar vector. So I am doing like this, this is the same magnitude but quite opposite direction, so this is what, minus b bar. Now you can understand that the tail of this a bar vector to the head of the b bar minus b bar vector, if you join, you will get the resultant, that is a bar minus b bar. Now if you join this one, tail of the a bar vector to the head of the minus b bar vector, this will give the resultant, that is a bar minus b bar. So this is the procedure to what, subtract the vectors. So you have to understand subtraction of vectors is nothing but adding of a vector and a negative vector which we want to be subtracted. Next, now we'll go to the discussion of next we'll be go to the discussion of the polygon of vectors. So what is the polygon of vectors, we'll be discuss it now. If n sides are there, if n sides are there, if they are representing the sides of a polygon in both magnitude and direction, then the resultant of that n sides we can find like this. Suppose if I am vectors I am taking, number of vectors I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4. Here a bar, b bar, c bar and d bar vector. So these n vectors we taken as a sides of a polygon, taken in order. Then in this polygon we have a closing side. This closing side of the polygon, which is taken in the reverse order, will give the resultant of these vectors. Now these we took in the anti-clockwise direction. Now the closing side, whatever we are taking, that should be taken in the clockwise. That will give the resultant of these a bar vector, b bar and c bar and d bar. Now I am doing the same thing here. Now I am joining the tail of the a bar vector to the last vector d bar here. Now if I join this one, and which order I am doing this one, this is in anti-clockwise but I am doing in the clockwise. So this will give the resultant of these vectors, that is r bar equal to a bar plus b bar plus c bar plus d bar. So what you understand here, the polygon of vectors means, you know, polygon means many sides are there. If a number of vectors are taken as the sides of a polygon which is taken in the one order, then the resultant of the polygon which is taken in the reverse order, which is the closing side gives the resultant of all the other vectors. So this is called as the polygon of vectors. So in this polygon of vectors, I am saying that the closing side will give the resultant. But if the closing side, if you take it in the same order as we taken in the whatever the vectors we taken first, The same order if you take in this one, then the resultant of all those vectors will becomes 0. Why? Because you know here r bar equal to a bar plus b bar plus c bar plus d bar. Now a bar plus b bar plus c bar plus d bar plus of minus r bar is equal to what is we are getting? 0. So the vectors a bar plus b bar plus c bar plus d bar, and if you add minus of this resultant, means minus of this resultant means we have to be making reverse of it. When we are making reverse of it, then all the vectors are concerned at the same order. Then what will happen if all the vectors are concerned at the same order? Resultant will become 0. So you can observe that is we are doing there. Suppose the same thing I am doing, if n vectors are there like this, a bar, b bar, c bar and d bar. Now earlier if I taken in the reverse order, I got the resultant. Now if I taken in the same order, what I will get here is, this is r bar, then all these summation is becomes 0. So how can we use this one? For example, how can we use this one and what kind of related problems it will ask? It means, let us suppose a force is there. A force is there which is having 5 units. Will be there that a force is there. Example, if a force F equal to 5 newtons is there. This kind of forces, how many we have is 12 forces are there. A force of 5 newtons such type of forces 12 is acting on a body by making 30 degrees with the next one, with the consecutive one. So if a force is there which is whose magnitude is 5 newtons, such type of forces, how many we have here? Yeah, 12 forces are there, and they are acting on a body by making an angle 30 degrees with the consecutive one. Then what is the resultant force acting over it? So what you understand here, in the polygonal vectors, if all the vectors form a closed polygon, what happened here? Resultant will be 0. So all the vectors form a closed polygon means what is the angle here making here is 360 degrees. So whether these 12 forces with this angle, if they are making 360 degrees or not, you have to understand. So if it is making 360 degrees means, so if these 12 forces are forming the closed polygon means, we have to understand that its resultant will be 0, or else its resultant is not 0. So you can here angle made by one with the other one is 30 degrees. So now how many vectors will form the closed polygon means, how can we find it out? The one is, so 360 degrees by given angle with the consecutive one. So what is the given angle here? 30 degrees. So how many will come here is 12. So how many closed sides are there with the 30 degrees consecutive angle means 12 sides. And the given sides also here, given forces also be 12. Definitely with this angle, 12 forces will form the closed polygon. If it is formed the closed polygon means, what you understand here? Resultant is 0. So we can say these all forces is acting. So if these all forces are forming the closed polygon, then we can say resultant will be 0. So what you have here is these 12 forces, these 12 forces forms closed polygon. Forms closed polygon. Therefore, resultant is equals to 0. Let us suppose if they are not given in this same case, if they are not given what? So 12 forces, if they are given only 11 forces. 11 forces means what we will be having here is to complete the polygon. Here we have required the number of sides is 12. But If they give, we have 11 only, means we have left one side pending. Left one side pending is, see, if in this case, if 11 forces are given, so one side is the closing side. So the closing side is nothing but the resultant. That the resultant will be, resultant is equals to closing side. What is the closing side here is, we have 11 forces. In the 11 forces, out of 11 forces, 10 forces there forms the equal and opposite pairs. So because even in this 10 pairs are there, they are equal and opposite. Equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. They will be cancelling each other. Still what will be left here is, one force will be left. That force is counterbalanced with the closing side. So we can say the resultant will be one force. That force is nothing but how much here is? 5 newtons. So if 12 forces are given, the 12 forces will form the closing polygon, that time resultant will be 0. When 11 forces are there, still we have one left, that is also will be the resultant. Then what happens here? The resultant force is equals to 5 newtons, we can say. So like this, polygon of vectors is there. So if n vectors is given, then we, based on that, we can able to find the resultant. Next, we will go to the discussion of this is the way, the graphical method. In this also, we can also discuss the hexagon example. That is, suppose here, if a vector MOA, A bar, it is OB, B bar, and so these two resultant will be, what you can take here, these two resultant will be from this tail of the first vector to the head of the second vector. If you join it, what it will give you, that A bar plus B bar. Next, so one more side if you take, and this is BC, C bar. Now, if you join this one, so this is A bar plus B bar vector, and tail of this A bar plus B bar vector to C bar vector head, if you joining, what this vector will give you? That is nothing but a summation of these two, that is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Next, again, if you take the one more parallel side, now if you join these two, this is CD, D bar vector. Now we are connecting the A bar plus B bar plus C bar vector to the head of that B bar vector. What about this one? This will give us the A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus D bar. Next, if you are taking the one more vector here, E bar. Now, if you join this one, if you join the tail of the first vector to, you can understand clearly, the tail of this A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus D bar vector to the head of the E bar vector, means what will give you this one? This will give you this, this will give you the resultant of all these. What is the resultant of all these? Means this vector plus this vector summation, you can understand. That is A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus D bar plus E bar. From this also you can understand that, see, these are all vectors up to E, we taken in one hand. So they are all what? A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus D bar plus E bar. Now, if you connected the closing set in the reverse order, what we have, this was the resultant of all these vectors or not? So, this is we took in the reverse order direction. So this is nothing but this one plus this one addition only. That is, we wrote like this. So So this in this way, x sub 1 case also can understand how the closing set gives the resultant of all the remaining vectors. Next. So this is the way graphically to add the vectors. But graphically adding the vectors is a little bit complicated. So it is simpler one is by adding the vectors analytically, means component method. It is quite simple. So before going to the component method, first of all we have to know what is the resolution of vectors. So first we will finish the resolution of vectors, then we will go to the analytical method, addition of vectors in analytical method. And this resolution of vectors is very important concept, but understand well. Resolution of vectors. Yesterday we discussed orthogonal unit vectors. What is the meaning of orthogonal unit vectors? Means to represent any physical quantity along x direction or y direction or z direction, we have a unit vectors called I cap, j cap and k cap. So if a body is moving along x direction having 3 units is there, means if it is moving along x direction means having 3 units are there, then we can write the displacement vector s bar is equals to 3 i cap, because it is moving along x direction. Or else if it is moving along y direction means, if it is moving along y direction with 4 units means, we can write as displacement vector like s bar as 4, it was the axis here y direction, so what we will write the unit vector magnitude and direction is j. Like that if it is moving along z direction, we can represent with the direction as k cap. But if the body is moving along xy plane, if it is moving in xy plane, so we have to be transform its magnitude along x direction as well as along y direction. That transforming the magnitude into x direction and y direction is called resolution. So that is how to resolve it, we will be discuss it now. Suppose if you take the coordinate system, so first we will be discuss the resolution of vectors in 2 dimension, otherwise rectangular components in 2 dimension, then based if you understand that, that is quite simple to understand the 3 dimension. First I am going to take the 2 dimension xy plane. Here any one vector, let us assume, so the vector which is in a plane, in xy plane, let us suppose this is a vector, let this vector is r bar. See, if this r bar is makes an angle theta with x axis, you understand that if you are taking this, if this r bar magnitude, if you are rotating slowly either this way along y side or x side, what happens, the projection whatever it is there over the x axis or y axis keep on changes. So if you are completely placed along the x axis, its projection will be, projection means if you put a light here, its shadow will be formed over the x axis, so then maximum length will be there. And if you keep here like this, the maximum length will be placed on the y axis. But if the keep the angles keep on changes, what happens here, some magnitude going to be changed from x axis to y axis. When you are going to slowly rotating from x to y, what happens here, magnitudes keep on decreases on x axis. So how can we understand, how can we transform this r bar onto x direction and y direction? Means simple thing, just you have to draw the perpendicular lines from tail of the vector to the head of the vector on x direction, as well as tail of the vector to the head of the vector onto the y axis. That's it. So to resolve this vector into components, what I am going to do is I am drawing the perpendiculars from tail of the vector to the head of the vector on the x direction, x axis. Same way I am drawing the normals on the y axis. Then let us suppose it is O, it is Q, it is R. So OP, QR. Now this is or else you can take O, A, B, C. Now this is forms a triangle. What is the projection we took on x direction? This is what we can call it as a x component. And this will be what? Y component. Then this is OA bar, AC bar. AC bar and OB bar both are same. Now you know additional vectors graphically we discussed previously there. From that OC bar equal to what you can write? OA bar plus what? AC bar. AC bar and OB bar parallel vectors, equal vectors. So same magnitude, same direction. So AC bar and OB bar vectors are same. Then this triangle, from triangle OAC, say from triangle OAC, what you can write? OC bar is equal to OA bar plus AC bar. What about OC bar? That is the resultant vector R bar. And OA bar means X. And in which direction was there? X axis. So x axis means how can we represent in x axis direction means by multiplying with unit vector I cap. So I am writing OA bar means here x magnitude direction is I cap. The same way AC bar is same as OB bar. So OA bar plus OB bar. So OB bar means along which direction it is along y axis. So y axis means you have, what is the unit vector to represent the y axis means, that is j cap. So OA bar means x I cap and OB bar means y j cap. Here you can write what is x and what is y. You may ask like that. So what is x and what is y means? Here I cap is a unit vector. What is I cap unit vector? You can write I cap is equals to vector by its magnitude. Vector by its magnitude in the sense, here OA bar by, what is the magnitude? Modulus of OA bar. Similarly, J cap means OB bar by modulus of OB bar. Next, this X and Y values how can you determine means? By taking the triangles OAC, observe x, if you wanted cos angle, if you taken cos theta is equals to x by magnitude of R. So from triangle OAC, cos theta is equals to, we can write as a x by magnitude of R. Therefore x is equals to, we can write R cos theta. Similarly, from the same triangle sine theta, if you take it, that is AC. So AC by R. So sine theta equal to, that is AC in the sense what? Y. So we can write as a Y by modulus of R. That is equal to, we can write Y equal to R sine theta. So R cos theta is the component of R bar vector along x direction. And R sin theta is the component of vector in the y direction. Then this resultant vector, how can you write? This resultant vector x I cap plus y j cap. What is x here? R cos theta. Y means R sin theta. Therefore R bar equal to, we can write R cos theta I cap plus R sin theta j cap. So this is the resolution. What is the meaning of resolution? You can understand. Resolution means it is the process of what? Describing the components and the component vectors, you can call. Describing it to the component vectors here. And the component vectors, if you add vectorially by using addition vector addition, we add those component vectors. What we are getting here? Resultant we are getting. So the resolution is a process of what? Resolving the components vector into components, and those component vectors again if you added vectorially, that will give the resultant. And is this resultant magnitude how much, and how can you measure this angle if you know the vectors, if you know the components? That is, we will be discussing now. Here by taking this triangle OC square is equals to OA square plus S square. So from triangle OAC, from Pythagoras theorem, OC square is equals to OA square plus AC square, that is R square, magnitudes is a R square is equals to X square plus Y square. Therefore, magnitude of R equal to root over x square plus y square. That is what we wrote here, x component square plus y component square. So resultant vector R magnitude is equal to x component square plus y component square. Next, what about the direction? Direction means what is the angle made by the resultant vector with x-axis, particularly we are telling. So with x-axis means that angle we can find by taking the what opposite side by adjacent, means which trigonometric ratio we need with tan angle. So tan theta, you take it, that is what we will get, y by x, that is y component by x component. So this is the tan angle. So therefore here theta equal to tan inverse of y by x. So one thing I can tell you here, for example, only one thing you have to understand, if you give a simple vector like this, example, suppose a bar equal to ax I cap plus ay j cap. If they given like this, if you want to find the magnitude of a, what we did here, magnitude of R in this case, what we discussed here, under root of x component square plus y component square, and what is the angle made by this vector with x axis. So this is the angle made by the vector with x axis. That is how we taken here, tan theta is equals to y component by x component. In these, how can you understand whether x component, y component? I cap coefficient is x component, j cap coefficient is y component. So this is x component and this is y component. Now if you want to find the magnitude of this, how we did like that? Same way, magnitude of a bar equal to under root of ax square plus ay square. And next we can discuss that how much of angle made by this vector with x axis, means we can take that tan theta equal to y component by x component. So in this case it is angle made with x axis means tan theta equal to y component is ay by ax, that is theta equal to tan inverse of ay by ax. So one simple example we can take it here. Suppose if the given vector is, example, if a vector a bar equal to I cap plus j cap, what is the angle made by this vector with x axis, if we ask you. So angle made by the vector with x axis means what you want it here, you have to find it out the theta. Theta means what we know, that is nothing but tan inverse of y component by x component. What is the angle? Angle made by vector with x axis means x direction. You want to find the angle made by the vector with x axis means already we did. So we found that formula here. We have theta equal to tan inverse of y component by x component. What is y component here? J coefficient. What is x component here? I coefficient. Here, nothing is there, means that is nothing but 1. Here, I coefficient is 1. So, y component is 1 by 1. So, tan inverse of 1 is nothing but 45 degree. So, like this, you can able to find the what is the angle made by the vector with the x axis. Again, we can discuss one more example. How it is easy, comparing to the graphical method, how it is easy to use the component method compared to the graphical method is, let us suppose I have a vectors like this, few vectors I am taking, a vector, one vector having 5 units, otherwise you take any one displacement vector, let it be 5 meters. Like this, which is makes an angle 53 degrees with the x axis. This is one vector, that is O A. Next, after that it was displaced to another direction along x direction, it is A B, that is A B bar vector, and it is 4 meters. Again it is turned into another direction along the vertically upwards. So here, like this, this is B, C bar vector, and its unit is, that is 4, 3 meters magnitude. So, this is graphical. If you want to determine the resultant, it is a little bit complicated. And easily, how can we do this one is by using the what component method. Component method means we know vectors all are in the same direction. We can add those vectors. So, the vectors which is along the x direction, along the y direction, no need to resolve it. But the vector which is in a plane, making certain angle with the x axis, means that we have to be resolving to components. Here, AB is nothing but 4 I cap, because it is along x direction. BC bar is nothing but 3 J cap, why? Because it is along y direction. But what about the OA? That is what to be resolve. This one only we need to be resolved. These two they are along x and y, no need to be resolved those. So first I am resolving this one. So OA bar. Here OA bar. So what we discussed with resolution means x component I cap, x component into I cap plus y component into j cap. What about x component into I cap, y component into j cap means already we discussed that. That is r, if it is r, if you taken r cos theta into I cap, r sin theta into y cap, already just you recap the previous one, then you can understand r means here 5. So 5 cos 53 I cap. Same way r sin theta means here 5 sin 53 j cap. So we can write here 5 cos 53 degrees I cap plus y means here 5 sin 53 degrees j cap. So we have a triangle, right angle triangle like this. If the angle is 50 degrees, so this will be 4, it is 3 units, then it will be 5 units. Then you can understand here from this triangle, cos 53 degrees is nothing but 3 by 5, sin 53 degrees is nothing but 4 by 5. Then if you substitute there, so 5 into 3 by 5 means 3, that is 3 I cap plus 5 into 4 by 5 is nothing but 4 j cap. So this 5 units, 5 meters displacement was resolved as x direction as 3 units, in the y direction as 4 units. Then this is OA bar. Then what about the resultant vector of these is, resultant means here, r bar is the resultant I am taking. What about resultant? That is OA bar plus AB bar plus BC bar. What is AB here? OA is being discussed. And what about it? AB bar, AB bar is along x direction, so magnitude is 4, x direction unit vector is I cap. and BC bar is nothing but along y direction, its magnitude is 3, unit vector is j cap. Now r bar is nothing but OA bar plus AB bar plus BC bar. Then what about OA here? OA is nothing but 3i cap plus 4j cap plus AB bar is nothing but 4i cap, BC bar is nothing but 3j cap. Then it will be 3 means 7i cap, 4j plus 3j is 7j cap. Then this is the vector, resultant vector. Then what about the magnitude of OC? That is r bar is nothing but OC. The resultant will be root over x component square plus y component square, that is 7 root 2 meters. So this is the resultant of this vector. So quite simple here, just by resolving it we found the resultant of it. So in the same way, one more point is, if a vector is there, if you are rotating into, by making certain angle, if you are rotating along the origin, if you are rotated, that angle, if it is integral multiple of 2 pi, it won't be changed, even its direction wise, or else it is in the magnitude wise. But if you are not rotating in the integral multiple of 2 pi, if you are rotating in a other than integral multiple of 2 pi, then what will happen means magnitude will be remain same, but direction will be goes to change. So that is one example we can discuss it. Here, if a vector is rotated other than integral multiple of, not in the integral multiple of of 2 pi, its magnitude will remain same, but the direction changes, so vector will be going to change. Vector changes in direction wise, but magnitude is remains same. See one example. So if a vector is there, let us suppose the A bar vector is there, that is we have root 3 I cap plus J cap. So this example we taken, and this example A bar vector, let us suppose if it is makes an angle, if this A bar vector, A bar equal to root 3 I cap plus J cap. So if it is rotated, not in the integral multiple of 2 pi, means if I am rotating a 30 degrees angle, like this, if I am rotating in a 30 degrees angle, then what is the new vector? If it is rotating to 30 degrees, what is the new vector? See, just we discussed that if it is not in the integral multiple of 2 pi, what is going to be changed? Direction wise it is changes, but magnitude will be remains same. So when it is rotated through 30 degrees, that vector is comes in which direction? Here is that vector is comes under the x direction. Then what about its magnitude? Magnitude A bar is equals to root over root 3 square plus 1 square, that is 3 plus 1 is 2 units, means 2 here units I am taking, 2 units. Then now the magnitude is 2 units, it will be remain same, but if it is rotated to 30 degrees, it will comes this new vector is comes under the x direction. So the new vector magnitude is same. So modulus of A bar magnitude is same, but direction is along x axis. So x axis in the sense, we can represent with a unit vector called I cap. So it is 2 I cap. This is the new vector. Like this, we can able to find out this one.